Mr. Speaker, I rise in strong opposition to this bill, which chooses to slash programs that help struggling families get back on their feet without closing a single tax loophole or limiting a single special interest subsidy. Our budget should reflect our values, and as many in the faith community have argued, it should advance the moral responsibilities of the nation to provide for the common good. I note that the Catholic bishops just sent a letter concluding that, and I quote, "The proposed cuts to programs in the Republican budget reconciliation fail this basic moral test," end quote. I'm pleased that the bishops are speaking out, as they should. 40% of the total cuts here come from cutting assistance to low, moderate income families, including food stamps, Medicaid, the Children's Health Insurance Program, social services for vulnerable children and elderly and disabled people. But instead of eliminating big agricultural subsidies where people don't have to plant a seed and they get paid, this budget would cause more than 200,000 children to lose their school lunch, would cut the food stamp program by $36 billion. That means 46 million Americans, one half of whom are children, would see their benefits cut, and 2 million Americans would lose them entirely. This at a time when 1 in 7 seniors faces the threat of hunger, and 1 in 5 children right here in America, a land of plenty, face a similar risk. They are going to bed hungry in the United States of America. We know the impact of hunger and malnutrition, lower performances at school, poor growth, an immune system less able to fend off illness. Instead of ending subsidies to big oil companies, this budget eliminates the social services block grant, which provides child care assistance to low-income working mothers, addresses child abuse, provides a care for the elderly and disabled. About 23 million people, half of them children, will lose services. Instead of ending tax breaks that allow corporations to ship jobs overseas, this budget cuts Medicaid, slashes the Children's Health Insurance Program, forces 350,000 Americans to forego health care coverage provided by the health care reform. Instead of asking millionaires to pay the same tax rates as middle-class families, this budget makes children who are U.S. citizens but have immigrant parents ineligible for the child tax credit, harming 2 million families and 4.5 million children who are United States citizens. They end the Medicare guarantee for seniors in this nation. These cuts have a catastrophic effect on the most vulnerable in our nation, and for what? All to protect special interest subsidies, tax breaks for the richest members of our society. My friends, it's $150,000 for the average millionaire in a tax cut. That's what we're talking about in this piece of legislation. It is wrong. Budgets are about choices, about values, and this bill exposes exactly what this majority is all about. We need to pass legislation that strengthens, rebuilds the middle class of this country, creates jobs, invests in rebuilding our infrastructure, supports manufacturers, and restores fairness to our tax code. This reverse Robin Hood agenda of the House majority fails in every single regard, and I urge my colleagues to oppose it. Yield back.